Yet another exotic with cooldown properties. The Warlock exotic gauntlets, the Karnstein armlets, have similarities with other Warlock exotics, like the Eye of Another World, Nezarek Sin, and the Crown of Tempests. By similarities, I mean they offer the same results, but with different means of achieving them. Nezarek requires void damage kills to trigger ability cooldowns, Crown of Tempests requires arc ability kills to trigger cooldowns, and Eye of Another World offers cooldowns for nothing, but the cooldown is pretty insignificant. The exotic perk on the Karnstein armlets gives ability energy and health back for melee attacking enemies. Once again, the amount of ability energy and health you get back isn't specified, so let's do some testing. Melee attacking an enemy will grant a small amount of your grenade, melee, and rift ability back, but how much does it actually give back? Really not a lot. If I had to put a percentage on it, I would probably say about 5-7% per melee attack. As for the health you get back per melee attack, again, really not a lot. To put this into perspective, to go from empty to full ability energy, you will need to melee attack an enemy or multiple enemies somewhere between 8 to 13 times, depending on how frequently you attack enemies and how much your abilities cooldown in the background. Even though there is no buff message on the side of your screen to show that the Karnstein's perk is working, there does seem to be an internal cooldown on the exotic perk. If you rapidly strike an enemy, the health and ability energy will not trigger back to back, so try to space your melee attacks out a little bit. Not a ton, but just enough as to refresh the timer. So to recap, the Karnsteins give a small amount of ability energy and health back for every melee attack you hit, so long as they are briefly spaced apart. Getting back to the build, the Karnsteins come stock with a mobility mod, which is okay, but I would recommend going for a kinetic loader mod since Paragon mods are very limited on gauntlets. Thinking about subclasses, the Karnsteins are completely neutral, so we need to consider all three options. Firstly though, let's think about what we're building for. The Karnsteins work with a Warlock's neutral game, being its abilities, and requires many melee attacks to get the most out of the exotic perk. As far as neutral games go, the Stormcaller is excellent with its pulse grenades and rising storm melee attacks. The configuration I would recommend for a Stormcaller would be the same configuration I used for the Nezarek Sin and Crown of Tempest video too, being the attunement of the elements. Utilize Rising Storm and the Karnsteins to get your melee attacks up as often as possible. Strike an enemy, rinse and repeat until you have your super. Literally a carbon copy of the Nezarek's build, except we're trading out void damage kills for melee attacks. Very sound build, but since I already suggested this for other exotics, let's keep looking. Dawnblade's neutral game, in my opinion, is just okay. Solar grenades are decent, fusions are alright, but both of these grenades can be enhanced by other exotics, like the Sun Braces and the Starfire Protocol respectively. Firebolts are pretty good in the Crucible, but the Karnsteins require you to get many melee attacks consecutively to get the most out of the exotic, which is not something you find often in the Crucible. I've always felt that Super is what makes Dawnblade a decent class, along with Phoenix Dive, both of which do not work in tandem with the Karnsteins. Given this, I wouldn't recommend using the Karnsteins with Dawnblade, especially not over something like the Sunbraces. Voidwalkers again have an outstanding neutral game, whether it be through overcharging your grenades in the Attunement of Chaos skill tree, or injecting your grenade with the Attunement of Hunger. Both options are good, and will work well with the Karnsteins. I can see the Devour build being quite strong, particularly since you're getting health back for every melee, and grenade and melee energy back to re-trigger the Devour effect. Assuming we'll go with the Attunement of Hunger, this gives us a melee-centric build that rewards us for playing aggressively, so let's consider the places to use it. I can't really recommend the Crucible. Melee attacks happen sometimes for sure, but only getting a couple here and there doesn't warrant using an exotic that's all about melee attacks in my opinion. The Karnsteins can definitely help you in the Crucible, but it will really depend on how you play. If you like to fly at people and go with hand-to-hand combat frequently, then the Karnsteins might be an alright Crucible choice. But if you like to play differently, probably go with something else like Crown or Nezarek. Alright, PvE. Melee attacking adds in Destiny 2 is something that you end up doing all the time, so creating a build for it isn't too hard. Against waves of low, mid, and even some higher tiered enemies, the Karnsteins with the Devour Voidwalker build will reward you for playing up in the enemy's faces, with constant health regen and ability energy. Places to use the build, most activities, actually probably all PvE activities, outside of actual boss fights. You don't typically want to get into a boxing match with a raid or strike boss in D2, but dealing with the waves of adds in the build up to the boss fight, whether it be in public events, strikes, or even the Castellum in the Leviathan raid, the Karnsteins will serve any Warlock well, particularly if you like to play aggressively. So what do you guys think of the Karnstein armlets? Do you rate them higher than other Warlock ability exotics like the Nezarek and the Crown of Tempests? Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, guys.